services companies means. Because by product, you mean?
The core product.
Yeah, but the sort of integrative market sales process design, the whole, that's the whole thing.
Yes.
Which has not traditionally been the case in financial services, that they've been much, to your earlier point, they've been much more silent.
Yes. Well, but at least it's the offering team should get that feedback, right? The offering of how you package up that offering, how you cross-sell that offering. That's at least the piece. But this, it's this idea that we're moving in. When you start thinking about the subscription model, right, and where the whole new economy is going, the more that we move into a subscription model, whether you think about an Uber or an Airbnb, the dynamics of the subscription model, and whether I sign up every month, is almost like a constant NPS. It's a constant temperature of telling you whether or not your product is meeting the needs of your consumer. Because if they don't sign up the next month, you know your product is, there's something wrong with your product. But if your growth line's going like this, then you know your product's starting to take off.
Yeah.
And you should be refining that product so you actually start to get that arc of that curve going on. And I do think that this new generation is getting very comfortable with a subscription model. I mean, I know my kids do not want to own a car. They'll take a Zip car before they, it's amazing to me. I couldn't wait for my 1969 Le Mans to come. I was so excited about my first car. My son could care less. He wants to know how he can sign up for Zip car. It's like it's a whole asset and that I was so proud of when in my generation, he could care less about that. He just wants to get somewhere to go somewhere, and that's the subscription model he's in.
Yeah.
But if Zipcar doesn't work for him, he's going to another alternative.
Well, I think your point is that model forces you to be smarter
and get your product.
You get much more immediate feedback.
You get constant feedback on an ongoing basis. So if your product around a savings model or a savings fund is not working, people don't sign up for it, you should get that feedback right away and you should change your product.
I want to hear one more audience question before we run out of time. There's this question about, there is so much happening in terms of new startup offerings, new tech coming online. If I'm thinking about finding partners, how do I sort through all that? Whether it's technology partners that I don't bet on the wrong horse, or if it's business partners, how do I just sort through that and actually make responsible decisions at the velocity things are changing?
Yeah, so you have to, as a sort of an institution, build the foundation to test these partners. So you have to have this infrastructure layer and this data layer and this AI layer that these partners plug into. Now, there's two approaches to that. Obviously, you're not going to plug it into your main system. So you need to know what your infrastructure layers are, from cloud to AI to data strategy. Get that firmed up and where you're going. And then you plug them in. But before you plug them in, you actually have this 10% of your time spending on innovation to see what they can do and what they can't do. And you should be able to swap them out. So for example, on my digital commerce platform, I know my digital commerce platform, there's an infrastructure in place. But when Seismic comes in and wants to sort of help me with sales enablement tools, I tested Seismic before I put it into the main system, right? So there's a tool called Intercom. We're testing Intercom for communication. I'm testing that tool before I move it in. So it's sort of like you create this playground before it gets into the main system, especially in a financial services institution when you sort of have to get through the regulatory environment. But philosophically, you have to say, this is the core infrastructure that I'm on, that I'm gonna plug and play those players in.
Yeah.
And I do think, you know, you should be spending 10, 15% of your time on innovation. You should be opening up your APIs. MasterCard's done a phenomenal job with that. You know, Citibank has an innovation center in Dublin where they bring their customers in and they start innovating with them. You know, at IBM we have design thinking sessions. So there's a lot of places where you as a customer can sort of leverage your partners to do sort of design thinking and innovation thinking before you start just plugging companies in.
We're just about out of time. I want to ask you one last thing. If you think about where this is headed, the example I always think of is Stitch Fix. The shopping experience from department store to what Stitch Fix is trying to do actually feels a lot like where banking ought to head. What's your sort of, that's my mental model, which I think is basically, look, the problem in financial services has been, why is this so hard?
Yeah.
The question is going to be, why isn't it done yet?
Yeah.
What's your mental model of where we're headed? How do you think about the future?
Yeah, look, I think the reason why some of these models are working really well is because they're going to the consumer and understanding their lifestyle and their arc, and they're understanding what their needs are. I'd suggest to you the financial services institution, I think they know what the answer is in a lot of cases, but they haven't really been able to figure out how to get over the barrier of the old. It's almost like you got this engine running that's going really, really fast, bringing you in a lot of profit and a lot of revenue. And they know what the second engine, how to get that second engine started, but they can't actually get the velocity going on it because there's a lot of regulatory or biases or corporate policies that won't allow them to do it. So I do think that the financial services, the companies I've worked with, I absolutely think they know what the answer is around life cycle management and sort of life cycle stage and what are the products we want to offer. It just, it's they're not getting there. But I do think the good news is they are embracing key things around know your customer, around payment, around transferring funds. I think the new generation is forcing them to adopt some of these things, which will ultimately force them to change their corporate policies.
Okay, great. We'll have to leave it there. Thanks, Bob.
All right, thanks. That's fine.